Good morning, one and all. Sitara welcomes you to its Zoom meetings. In continuation of the series, today we have the topic operating ratios, and the speaker is CM Nageshwar Rao, senior instructor at Sitara. A brief introduction of Sri Nageshwar Rao. Mr. Nageshwar Rao has been a senior instructor in this academy from the year 2015. He has qualified Appendix PA examination and has stood as All India topper in the year 1999 in SOS stream. And subsequently in the year 2000, he has passed the TIA examination also. He is an author of the book Railway Accounts Made Easy, which is published by Sitara. And also he runs a blog, Appendix 3 exam, and also mobile app for the benefit of all those aspiring for railway examinations, departmental examinations. Mr. Nageshwar Rao has varied experience in teaching railway account subjects at various training institutes at Secunderabad. We are indeed fortunate to have him on this topic because this is a very important topic which will always appear in the examination either as a main question or as a short note. I hope all the participants will be benefited by his experience and teaching today. Thank you, one and all. Over to Mr. Nageshwar Rao.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Good morning, all of you.
Good morning, sir.
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 Good morning, all of you. Now we start the session. Before that, I would like to greet all of you. Please cooperate with me.
Yes, sir. Portable.
At the end of session, I will share this article in the Zoom chat box and as well as what's on you. Hope this is useful to all of you. Before starting any queries, please ask us. Otherwise, we will schedule at the end of the session. This is all clarifications. Operating ratio in Indian Railways. Operating ratio in Indian Railways. See, we are going to cover various parameters in the Indian Railways. The calculation of operating ratio, how to calculate, and how to calculate net revenue or net receipts or surplus or shortfall. And we do some poor practical problems because the exam and LCE, the process of practical also lost. And the performance efficiency gets by diligence, and what are the differences between operating ratio and OEA? PA, what we're going to cover. Prior to that, what is the ratio? What is ratio? Because this is operating ratio, it's important that what is ratio? A ratio is a relationship expressed in mathematical terms between two figures and cause and effect relationship. All connected in software are. You could take this operating ratio, say, the different relationship between the gross working expenses and gross earnings. So it is a mathematical expression. Sometimes it is expressed in the percentage. The two figures are cause and effect relationship. And an expression of the quantitative relationship that existed between two numbers. So, one of the ratios of parameters described in the Indian Railways, that is the para number 510 of Indian Railways Administration and Finance Code. They are disclosing the almost six types of ratios and parameters. The first one is called operating ratio. It is the today's topic. We discuss at length after this completion with six ratios. So this is nothing but percentage of gross operating expenses to gross earnings. So it should be as low as possible. That means it is the lower operating ratio, this is the emission one. And the next one is the percentage of net receipts or net revenue to the capital at charge and investment from capital. This is the another parameter, but this parameter has lost its relevance because of this capital at charge tax cease because there is no separate budget. 2017 and 18 financial year onwards, the railway budget is merged with the general budget. So it has lost its relevance. Nothing but this rate of return in the commercial terms. And carbon also is a percentage of surplus to capital at charge and investment from capital. So what is the difference between net receipts and surplus means dividends? So net receipts minus dividends is equal to surplus. So prior to 2017 and 18, we are calculating this percentage of surplus to capital at charge and investment from capital. Since this capital charge is tax season, due to merger, this also has lost its relevance. But these both ratios, the second and third, should be as high as possible because it is like a rate of return or return on capital employed, ROC or ROE. And fourth one is the current assets or current liabilities. Here it is a two categories then. The number one is the stores in stock in terms of months consumption. That means the closing balance of the stock is divided by the months consumption. What is the average month consumption? That means it is a suppose if you take the example that on 30th June the stock is 1000 numbers, months consumption is 500 numbers. That is nothing but it is a 2 months consumption is kept as stock balance. So it should be as low as possible. At the time that same time service level should not be counted. And if it is a high what we have done, this dividend liability or blocking of capital. And another one of the current assets of current liabilities is the works in progress as a percentage of value in the WMS. This is nothing but percentage of closing balance to total credits. Take example, this is 60 by 2000 to 100 is equal to 3%. So normally in the repair workshops, the ideal percentage is 3%. In the manufacturing workshops, the ideal percentage is 6%. Second one, this is all of you know, this is the turnover ratio. Turnover ratio, that is the stores inventory as percentage of the total issue of the stores. What is the formula of turnover ratio? The stores in stock as of 31st March divided by total issues during the financial year into 100. That is, if you take a small example, 400 is the stock balance at the end of 31st March. The total issues may be 2000, so the percentage is at 20%. So it is calculated here or not, both subjective we have calculated. So this is also, it should be as low as possible. Thus, to avoid blocking of capital, and the last ratio is unrealized earnings at the year end in terms of number of days and earnings. This is the parameter we used on the earning side, profit side. So what is the formula? Here formula is profit suspense as on 31st March divided by earnings per day. Earnings per day is nothing but total earnings divided by 365 is equal to earnings per day. So we'll take a small example here. Here in the example, the profit suspense on the 31st March is 200. The total earnings in the financial year is 36. So what is the earnings per day? Earnings per day is equal to 3650 divided by 365 days is equal to 10. Is the 10 rupees is the earnings per day. Now the formula is applied. The profit suspense divided by earnings per day 200 by 10 is equal to 20 days. That means it conveyed the average time for collection of the profit suspense are debtors. Profit suspense is nothing but in the commercial sense it is the debtors. That means the average time for collection of debtors is 20 days. So it should be as low as possible. That means we are clearing the debts, we are collecting the debts. Clearing some profit suspense is as efficient as possible. So this is shows. So these are the six ratios. Now we go for this is the main topic. This is operating ratio. Operating ratio, it is the code of conscience, is the pair of 308 and 434 of the Indian Railway Finance Book. It is regarded as the one of the most important financial statistics or ratios and has frequently been used as an index of the operating efficiency of the railway. So we come to definition. The definition of operating ratio is percentage of gross working expenses to gross earnings of any company. Normally we calculated this ratio for every year, not month or quarterly. So what is the two figures required? What is gross working expenses? Another is gross earnings. So the relationship between gross working expenses and gross earnings is nothing but operating. So in general, in simple, the operating ratio is the number of rupees spent to earn every 100 rupees. That means if the operating ratio is 75 rupees, means 75 rupees has been spent to earn 100 rupees. So what is the profit or earnings or some it's called 25 rupees. So this operating ratio should be as low as possible. Operating ratio is as low as it possible. That because the difference between this gross working expense and gross expense, it is a surplus or profit. So if it is the operating ratio is less than 100, the organization is in
profit.
If it is more than 100, the organization is in losses. Now we check what is gross working expense and what is gross expense. This is the formula. Gross working expenses divided by gross earnings into 100. So what is gross working expenses? It is ordinary working expenses plus appropriation to VRF and appropriation to pension. Please remember, this is not VRF open balance or closing balance. It is the during the current year, what is the appropriation to depreciation reserve fund? And what is appropriation to pension fund? This is a common method given number 440. 440 means all 3 to 13. 3 to 13 and plus 440. It is together, it is called gross working expenses. Here, please remember this expenses means it is a commercial term. Accrual accounting, not the actual accounting. Please remember. So then, coming to gross earnings. Gross earnings is nothing but X plus Y Z. Now, as per the relevant data, the earnings what we have to replace by the day. We will discuss at the end of this topic. So, what is gross earnings? Coaching earnings plus goods earnings plus sundry earnings. X plus Y plus Z. If any difference is there, we have to deduct before arriving the net. That means coaching earnings and preference is there. Preference we have to direct from coaching earnings. But we have to arrive net earnings only we have to use for this calculation of gross earnings. And here the important one is the apportioned earnings only. Because all of you know, since general earnings are treated as the profit sector, all earnings are apportioned among the all the earnings, not alternating earnings. Alternating earnings we should not take for calculation of operating ratio. So this is the completely commercial approach to this operating ratio. Now it is very important to check the glossary of terms that Para 308 of the Finance Code to understand, to better understand this operating ratio. So if you understand this table, this is the excerpt from the Para 308 of Finance Code, you will understand the entire railway's financial position, that is revenue output. Revenue. We'll check first credits. Credits. This is the coaching earnings less refunds. So we have to show net amount money. And goods earnings less refunds. Other together this express file is called profit earnings. This is as per the exact review of this report. We'll check another modified table also for this operating ratio. First we'll check this original one. So coaching earnings plus less refunds, goods earnings less refunds, both together is called profit earnings. So if we add sundry other earnings, that is a jet, an abstract jet, you will arrive gross earnings. Gross earnings. Here gross earnings, true or accrued earnings, because I told you that it is the commercial company, see the website called commercial. It's all earnings, it's commercial amount. That means whether this earnings realized or not is immaterial. Only booking of earnings is the very, very important. Accrued. Now, this is the linkage connecting the commercial and the government accounts is on earnings side is the profit and demand system. These two are the linkage on the earnings side. This is nothing but suspense. So the only in this statement, the suspense figure only at the plus or minus. The all other figures should be at the plus one. And all formulas if we check it is a plus one. Check 1 plus 2, again 3 plus 4, again this 5 plus 6. All figures will have to calculate to plus. There is no subtraction. But this figure may be minus or plus, the suspense. No confusion. And if we add suspense, now we are coming to government accounts. So this is the first part is the commercial accounts. The second part is the government accounts. The link between these two commercial and government accounts is the linkage, that is the suspense, profit suspense of demands. See, Indian Railways is the departmental so it is a on one part it is complete government, on another part we have to complete commercial. So here please remember the earnings. When you adjusted the suspense, we will arrive receipts. Receipts means it is an actual receipts. Applying the government accounts. So, this is means it is an actual business. So, now we are entering the government about it. So, gross business. Gross business is nothing but gross earnings plus suspects. Gross earnings plus suspects. Now, we add miscellaneous business. This is generally outside the scope of the government of zonal rights. What are the miscellaneous business? Guarantee recovery from the state governments and other miscellaneous receipts such as government share of surplus profits and profits on all public sector units, sale of land of subsidized companies, receipts from surcharge on the passenger base, all these are considered miscellaneous receipts. So if we add gross receipts and miscellaneous receipts, nothing but total revenue receipts. Total. This is the gross but credit side. Now we come to debit side. Debit side, the first one is the ordinary working expenses. Here also please check that this is the expenses. Expenses means it's only incurred whether the payment is made or not. Payment is made or not, it's so, on the ordinary working expenses, the appropriation to ERF and appropriation to pension fund. And altogether, this ordinary working expenses plus appropriation to DRO fund pension fund, it is called gross working expenses, or sometimes it is called total working expenses. Total working expenses, full expenses in an accounting period, whether or not actually dispersed or not. That is the point. So the difference between this gross earnings and gross working expenses is called net earnings. This is called net earnings. And this is the ratio between this gross working expenses and the total gross earnings. So what is the operating ratio formula? Gross working expenses divided by gross earnings into 100. And with this, this commercial part is over. Then the linked. The linked is connecting on the expenditure side is the demands field. Demands field. So if you adjust this suspense total working expenses, you will arrive gross expenditure. See, the word expense means it is a commercial principle. Expenditure means it is a government numbers. The working expenses actually dispersed during an account period is called expenditure. So from this point, this under this government numbers. So like in this credit side, debit side also miscellaneous expenditure is there. It's nothing but astral demand. One means this railway mode expenditure. Two is all miscellaneous expenditure general, that is surveys, audit, CTI, Central Engineering Institutes, and all other expenditure. Now, if we add this gross expenditure to miscellaneous expenditure, it is called total revenue expenditure. This will come to you. So the difference between total revenue receipts or total revenue expenditure is called net revenue or net receipts, and there is no dividend, so we may call it as surplus or shortfall also. Now please check, this is the very simplified operating ratio table, because I just modified this servo table, it is a cumbersome. Now check. This we can call it as credits. So what are the credits? Gross earnings plus suspense, gross receipts, add miscellaneous receipts, total revenue receipts. So please take some for example. This 200 is the gross earnings. Suspense is 5 rupees. See here the suspense, there is no minus sign, that means it is a plus sign. So 200 plus 5 is equal to 200 plus 5 is equal to 170. So gross earnings is 200, suspense is plus figure, this is because there is no minus sign, so this is a plus figure. So 200 plus suspense is for 205, miscellaneous receipts is the 50 rupees, so total revenue receipts is the 250 rupees. Now we check this total working expenses. This is nothing but ordinary working expenses plus DRF plus principal. Is altogether just imagine figure 160. Here I put the suspense with this the minus. So this is DP. So minus means we have to deduct 160 minus 10, 150. So that is a miscellaneous expenditure. If we add 25, the total revenue expenditure is the 170. So what is the operating ratio formula? Operating ratio formula is gross working expenses by gross earnings into 100. That is 160 divided by 200 into 100 is equal to 80%. This is 80% is the operating ratio. They ask what is the Rental means means rental means is nothing but difference between gross earnings and gross working expenses. What is the rental means here? Gross earnings is 200, gross working expenses is the 160. So the difference is 40 rupees is rental means. The operating ratio is 80%, and this surplus or net revenue is 45 rupees. So what is the difference? 45 rupees. This is, see, prior to 2017 and 2018, the dividend payment is there. So in such case, we have to deduct the dividend from 45, then we are in surplus. But from 2007, last 3 years, there is no dividend. So we can call it as, this is a net basis, or sometimes we use the word net revenue. And this is nothing but, since there is no dividend, it is as good as the surplus also. Suppose if the gross working expenditure, the gross expenditure is more than gross earnings, that means if it is the 275, then it is the shortfall. Shortfall is how much? 55 rupees. But here it is a plus amount only. Minus 175, it is a 45 rupees here is surplus. Suppose if the total revenue expenditure is more than total revenue, this is nothing but sharp. So this 45 rupees is distributed or appropriated among various other funds, because we already appropriated DRF and pension fund already the revenue stream. So the balance funds, that is called development fund, safety fund, and debt service fund, and RRSK, and capital fund, these amounts should be distributed or appropriated based on the recommendations of the Railway Convention Committee. Based on the recommendations of the Railway Convention Committee, this surplus is distributed among all various other funds. This operating ratio. Now we check the one practical example. All of you know this practical example. Now please check once again this table. You want to please note down this table in your notebook. See, this table is gross earnings plus suspenses equal to gross receipts plus miscellaneous receipts equal to total revenues. Only 3 years. Gross earnings, suspense, miscellaneous receipts. Gross earnings, if you adjust suspense, whether it is a plus, we have to plus, whether it is a minus, we have to get. So we will arrive gross receipts. And if we add miscellaneous receipts, then it is a total revenue receipts. On the right side, it is the gross working expenses, that is the ordinary working expenses plus VRF plus pension fund. This is all together, it is a divided by 160. Here the suspense are taken as the minus. So if it is a minus, you have to just to direct 150. And if you have miscellaneous expenditure, it is the total revenue. So the first part is commercial accounts. The middle part is the linked and connecting commercial and government accounts. And the last part is government accounts. So the formula is operating ratio of gross working expenses divided by gross earnings into 100 operating ratio. And the surplus or net revenue is nothing but total revenue receipts minus total revenue. Now this is the problem. Please try and post the answers in the chat box by selecting the Sitara. Please try. And before that, any doubts please ask. regarding calculation of operating ratio. Yeah, should we go for this practical problem?
Yes, sir.
Please, sir.
Sir, NPS including or excluding? NPS.
NPS, it is not, it is not, it is part of the number 13, partially working NPS. There is no question of data. Because it is part of Kamsatana, already working NPS.
सर मिसलेनियस रिसीप क्या हुआ मिसलेनियस रिसीप
मिसलेनियस रिसीप में इट इज अ ऑफसेट स्कोप ऑफ द इंडियन जोनल प्राइस दैट इज मिसलेनियस रिसीप प्लीज चेक डायरेक्टली गवर्नमेंट फ्रॉम द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट एंड गवर्नमेंट शेयर ऑफ द सरप्लस प्रॉफिट्स because we have so many public sector units in the northern and eastern. So the profits of RPSUs we call it as a miscellaneous business. And the sale of land of subsidized companies received from Sardar Jambi, passenger pay. Please do this operating ratio problem and post the answer in the chat box. After that, I'll show the solution. See, ordinary working expenses is 600, appropriation to DRP is 100, appropriation to pension fund 200, coaching earnings 300, boost earnings 600, salary earnings 100. So, from this figure information, we'll be able to calculate this operating ratio problem. And the suspense on the earnings side is the plus 25 and suspense on the expenses side is the minus 10. So if you adjust this suspense, you will arrive this gross receipts as well as gross expenditure. And if you add miscellaneous expenditure and miscellaneous receipts, you will arrive the surplus or shortfall. Yeah, please select, not everyone, please select the Sitara host. The chart box, please select the Sitara host and please submit your answer. Not the everyone. Yeah, very good. Ajay, very good. Yeah. Yeah, whatever surplus, Mr. Ajay, and Pratit, whatever surplus, please find out surplus also. Surplus. Jayanti madam, please check surplus. Yeah, very good. Wait for Kachi. Correct answer. law क्या is correct answer? Rajesh, please check your authentication formula. Rajesh, please check authentication formula. Your answer. Yeah, Sharma, you are right. Yes, Sharma. Devish Patak. Yeah, right.
हम लोग के दानदार
हम
लोग यार दानदार मंदिर में भी हम लोग
आते
हैं काफी तो मेरा आदमी है मेन आदमी हम काफी तो
मानते हैं Ajay Dupe, please check your answer. Okay, I will stop this. Now please check. Please check. Now please stop. What is the crossing its formula? That is x plus y plus z. That means coaching in its 300, course in its 600, subject in its 100. So what is the crossing its? It is the 1000. And what is cross working expense? Ordinary working expense plus appropriation theorem plus appropriation principle. That is 600 plus 100 plus 200. That is the 900.
Thank you.
Now please check the another problem. Yeah, please try to do the second one problem. Remove for that. Here are not events, coaching endings, boost endings, subject endings. And here are not events, ordering or doing expenses and accommodation. We are for accommodation. But other details, I publish. Please, from this, please calculate operating ratio on surplus or shortfall. Select the Sitara and post your answers. Now, Vishal, right answer. Please find out the surplus of shortfall. P.V. Sharma, please check your answer. Pradeep, please check your answer. Prakash, please check the answer. Prashant, please check. Anita's Galaxy, please check the answer. Because I intentionally hide the figures first, this gross working expense and gross earnings. Yeah, okay, we will check now. Stop there. Yeah, please check the answer. This is, see, I gave this gross, this is winner. What is the gross? This is winner. This is the 210. And I gave suspense on the inside my notice. So the gross receipts is 210 and the suspense on the inside is the 10 rupees. So that means please post the cable. 210 is the gross receipts and suspense is 10 rupees. So from admits to receipts you have to add. That means from receipts to admits you have to deduct. So that means 210 minus 10 is equal to 200 gross admits. So thus we can arrive the gross admits is 200. How we are arrived? Because the table of posted this gross receipts first and posted suspects. See, this gross earnings plus suspense is equal to gross earnings. Gross earnings minus suspense is equal to nothing but gross earnings. So from bottom to top, we can arrive, we can find this gross earnings. Now we'll check this gross working expenses. So gross expenditure I gave 150. And the suspense on my expense side, minus 9. That means we post just 150. And suspense is minus 10. See, from top to bottom, you are deducted. So from bottom to top, you just add. just had. So 150 plus 10 is nothing but gross working expenses, 160 rupees. So that means the operating ratio of Pharma is 160 by 200 into 100, that is 80% is the correct answer. 80% is the correct answer. And if you adjust this miscellaneous, this is plus 10, this is the 220, total revenue, this is the 220, whereas total revenue expenditure is the 220. That means here the shortfall, not surplus. This is the shortfall. What is the shortfall? Minus 1. So this is called as shortfall. Yeah, we stop this submitting answers. The 80% is the correct one, and minus 5 rupees is the shortfall. 5 rupees is the shortfall. Now check the other subject. Is there any ideal operating ratio for human lenders?
No.
There is no standard operating ratio or there is no ideal operating ratio. But in general worldwide, the railroad sector, the operating ratio 80% or more is the desirable or standard one. But what is the percentage? 80%. 80% is the desirable operating ratio or less. So what is the advantage of this operating ratio is the lower means. The lower operating ratio helps in generating more internal resources. If more internal resources means it is a we can spend more on the infrastructure. That is the lever number 16, plan expenditure. Plan requirement of plan expenditure. What are the plan expenditure? That means on safety side, that is the ROV or the LC gates, or can provide more amenities to passengers and staff, or other capital investment, that is the construction of new track, or acquisition of the rolling stock, or so many. Instead of depending on the borrowed amount or from the Ministry of Finance, we can able to meet our requirements in the better operating ratio. So it should be desirable as low as possible. The operating ratio is as low as possible, which is the ideal. So here in the operating ratio is the 2005 year is the very landmark, very important. Because prior to 2005, we are charged entire lease charges. Because almost 80-85% of rolling stock we are using in the Indian Railways is taken from IRFC on lease basis. Taken from IRFC on lease basis. So this we are paying lease charges every 6 months. So these lease charges, entire amount we are tempted to divide over 9 operating expenses of prior to 2005. But normally, if you pay EMI to housing loan, this housing loan EMI is constitutes principal as well as interest. Principal component as well as interest component, two components are. But we are not applying the principal, so prior to 2005, entire amount is tempted to as interest component. But that is the incorrect. So the audit has pointed out, audit is objective. And from 2005 year onwards, we are debited this capital component of the lease charges to be created planning for the other lease assets. And only interest component is charged to developer five. That means there is a good better relief. The great relief on the working expenses side. This has resulted in reduction of working expenses, and normally from 2005 year onwards, very improved operating ratio compared to prior to 2005. Because the burden of the ordinary working expenses reduced to that extent. Now, one question general asked, what are the initiatives or measures taken to achieve the lower or efficient operating ratio? So we'll check one by one. So it is nothing but either a reduction of gross working expense or increase the gross expense. either of it will help the lawyer or efficient operating patient. So what are the measures you can take? Maximize the competence. Maximize the competence. The only option is increasing the rates, but the government is not accepting. On the regulation of the fair and bright tariff,
no ticket.
On the effective market strategy, capture more and more profit because most of the profit is going to roadside. Now it is the our right hand to get back at the loss of the on the creation of the extra capacity, the construction of new lines, on the running of new lines, on the optimal utilization of the existing rail infrastructure. And generating more effort for non-fair labor. This is the latest concept. This is part of surveillance. And control of expenditure and economy and austerity measures and improve manpower planning and inventory management. Because inventory management where lot of capital is blocked up in the stores inventory. So we have to reduce as much as possible to avoid this blocking up capital. And optimizing the real condition. Because the developer tells operating expenses real almost constitutes 20 to 22% of the total working expenses. 20 to 22%. Previously it is 25 also, now it is reduced. So this is the best ever operating ratio. Best ever operating ratio is 74.7% in the 1963 and 1964. This is the efficient one. And if you check the last 2 years, it is around 90 to 100%. Not 90 to almost 96 to 97%. This is all because of we are undermining this accommodation to DR. We are provided very less amount because we are not using scientific method. It is only just on the basis of this RCC recommendation. So the 15-16 is better 91 and 90%, but from 17 and 18 onwards it is a 96%. Even in the last year COVID, it is almost more than 100%. But the government has given some amount towards pension fund. That's why we saved and we are below projected operating ratio below 100%. This 2022. This is the target for current year. We'll check how COVID is. Please check, this is the last year revenue budget. This is 2020-21. Coaching earnings is the 67,500 crores, almost 30% of the total earnings, 30%. And the share of course earnings is the 65%, so 147,000 crores. And salary earnings is the 5%. But our target of salary earnings is the 10% of the total earnings. Our target, but it is almost 5 or 6% only. We check the ordinary working expenses. Almost 75% is the ordinary working expenses. And if we take this appropriation to pension fund, almost 24%. That means only our staff, we use our staff expenditure, whether it is the salaries or pension, it is as good as 60% of total expenses. This is the major part. So here we are not able to appropriate sufficient amount on that year. This has nothing but resulted this creation of SRSF in the 2001 in the amount of 17,000 crores. In the 2001, the government has constituted an SRSF, Special Rider Safety Fund. That is also same objective replacement of old age assets. Because we are not providing sufficient amount under the year. Under the RRS also is nothing but it is all replacement of electrical assets, replacement of SMP assets, replacement of fan, and modernization of rolling stock. All these are nothing but the responsibilities of VR. Because not sufficient amount of VR, we have created RRSK. And suppose if we show or see the surplus, here we have distributed to RRSP of 5,000 crores. Had you appropriated this 5,000 crores in the year of PN, it means this is the 2,000 crores. That means almost our operating ratio is near to 99%. Just to make operating ratio very efficient one, we are showing the less amount in the year. Now check. Here the suspense is, what is suspense on any side? This is profit suspense, 100. So normally we always projected 100 crores only in the profit suspense. So if we add this 100 crores 225 plus 100 225 613, and we have projected miscellaneous, this is 300 crores. So total revenue is, this is the 2,25,900. Here the suspense, that is called dividends payable, minus 404 crores 70,000. So if you deduct it, it is a 2,16,730 crores. Here miscellaneous expenditure means that is a demand number 1,2,700 crores. See here miscellaneous expenditure demand number 1 and 2, this order expenses 3 to 30, and year after pension fund demand number 4. That means all the dividends are included in this statement, except the demand number 15. Anyway, that is not relevant. Dividends paid to general revenue is not relevant. So, out of demand 1 to 15, all 14 demands are included under this. This is 3 to 30, this is 1 and 2, miscellaneous expenditure, and for DR upon pension fund is the 14. So now we check. See here the total revenue, this is the 2,25,930 crores. Total revenue expenditure is 2,19,430 crores. The difference is the 6,500 crores. This is called net revenue or net receipt or surplus, because there is no dividend. So what is the net revenue? 6,500 crores. This 6,500 crores is appropriated to development fund, it is 1,500 crores, and RRSK 5,000 crores. That means this year there is no contribution or appropriation to capital fund or safety fund or this debt service fund also, there is no. And here the operating ratio is gross working expense by gross expense. What is gross working expense? We have checked. 217,117,516. And what is gross earnings? 225,51. So calculate gross working expense by gross earnings is 100. So the projected operating ratio is the 96.23%. This is the correct. And all of you know the external revenue as a separate operating ratio. We are calculating operating ratio for zonal revenues also, along with the main revenues. If we check the last year's statement provided by the Railway Board, the metro railway Kolkata is the highest operating ratio, 250. That means in the metro railway, the spending 250 rupees to earn 100 rupees. But I think 100 rupees, how much the metro railway is spending? 200 rupees. That is for this cost. But that is the highest operating ratio in the entire business. And the second highest operating ratio is the eastern railway from the top 1,725. Usually, for the last 20 years, the metro railway is not proper. Always highest. And when coming to lowest, the East Coast Railway correlation is the 15.5%. And the second lowest is the Southeast Central Railway Bilaspur. And we will check, is there any possibility of this comparing the operating ratio of Indian Railways with other countries' railway systems? It is not possible, because the calculation or computation methods are different from our country or another country. Because we are taking this gross working expense by gross earnings. They may include or exclude some other items. So it is not possible. So, and at the same time, this comparing of operating ratio of different journal values also is not advisable because of several unique factors, such as sometimes plants, accidents, natural resources, or other special factors. We cannot compare one journal value to another. Then it is better to compare operating ratio of particular journal value from year over, and that means what is the last year operating ratio, what is the current year operating ratio, if any negative is there, what are the steps to be taken, if it is there positive or what are the reasons for this efficient OR, we can analyze and we can make the action occur. So year over year is this. Now please check, this operating ratio is the best financial ratio to show the performance of the index. The answer is no, what are the results and which one is the alternative. Because this is the only way to check the efficiency of the operating performance, not the rate of return or return on capital. Because operating ratio itself is not a perfect indicator for judging the emissions of the journal. Why? Because of this. Here I have taken two examples. A railway capital is 1000 rupees. However, the gross earnings is 200 and gross working expenses is the 1. That is, what is the operating ratio of 1000 is for 7 rupees. And this B railway, the capital is 5000, whereas earnings is 2000. That means the capital 5000, they are able to deliver the performance of 2000 sales. And whereas gross working expenses is 69. So the 1600 by 2000 is nothing but the operating ratio 80%. That means 8% of the 400, that is the profit of the capital of 5%. So, if we check this operating ratio alone, the journal value A is the efficient. Journal value A is the efficient because it is the lowest operating ratio for that. But if we check the return on the capital employed, that is, what is the profit here? 50 rupees. 50 rupees on the capital, 1000. That means, what is the rate of return? Here only 5%. But if we check this rate of return on the B rate, it is the 8%. Because here profit is 400, whereas the investment is 5000. That on the investment of 5000, we are getting 400 rupees, is the 8%. So, if you compare this rate of return, this B railway is better than B railway. So, we have to take both the parameters, operating ratio and rate of return. We can judge whether it is efficient railway or not. To solve the combination of about two ratios, we will consider to evaluate the performance of railways instead of operating ratio. Now we come to diligence. Diligence is treated as the cost center, not profit center, because there is no mechanism of appropriation of this apportion that means the amount of diligence. There is no apportion of the DRF or pension fund about the diligence. Due to that, the diligence cannot be treated as the profit center. It is the cost center. So, even then, we are calculating this performance efficiency index for each and every unit. So, what is the formula? So, formula of performance efficiency index is the ratio of device 3 to 12 to alternate earnings. That means we are taking only alternate working expenses excluding given amount 30, and we are not taking the VRF pension fund, and we are taking only originating earnings because it is not possible to take a portion of the earnings among the earnings. So, other than we have calculated the limited information, the direct and the emissions of nutrients to the compare year to year. So what is the formula of PEI of nutrients? Nutrients 3 to 4 are divided by alternating units into. We'll check the difference between operating ratio and PEI. In the operating ratio, we are considering this 3 to 13. But in the performance efficiency index, only 3 to 4. But in some railways, in the SCR also, they take minimum of 13 also. But that is a negligible. Because entire minimum of 13 only to very low amounts, it is a bet from the pension fund. So 13 is always very lean event, small event. So whether you get 13 or not, it is not much impact. So some drivers are followed 3 to 12 and some drivers follow 3 to 12. And in the operating ratio, we always take in the apportioned endings, not alternating. But in the PEI, we are taking alternating endings. And here, appropriation to DRR for pension fund, we are taking for calculation of operating. Here there is no such a figures, so we are not considered to be impacted. And operating ratio is calculated for zonal values as well as Indian values. Whereas this PA is calculated for indigenous. So formula is here the gross working expense by gross earnings into earnings. Here the formula is the demands 3 to 12 divided by alternating earnings. And here, the earnings versus revenue. Now, the Railway Board recently circulated one letter on the initiative of Honorable Minister Piyush Goyal. Actually, the meaning of the earnings is nothing but profit. That means, after adjusting all expenses to the revenue, whatever surplus or shortfall is called, he said earnings. But normally, we use the world earnings instead of from the beginning. So the Railway Board recently advised not to use the word earnings, and hereafter we are supposed to use the word revenue. Because what is the definition of earnings? Definition of earnings means revenue minus expenditure, that means profit. But here coaching earnings is not profit, it is a total sales of the passenger earnings, passenger sales. So, using the word earnings so far, we have taken this correct. Because earnings means profit or surplus after deducting the expenditure from the. So, hereafter, this abstract X is called coaching revenue, abstract Y is called goods revenue, abstract Z is called sundry, not coaching revenue, earnings, goods earnings, sundry. This has to. So, it is high time to modify the revised accounting classification in the finance board value group according to the. We check the indicative is nothing but the war for Indian Railways, PEI for. This is the war formula. This is the PEI formula. This is the landmark year 2005. Very important because total year onwards the lease charges are bifurcated to capital and revenue components. And apportioned earnings is for our calculation of operating ratio, and this alternating earnings is for PEI ratio. So, highest operating ratio is the Metro Railway Kolkata always, and in the commercial plans. Side we use the words earnings and expenses. Whereas in the government side we use receipts and expenditure. Expenses means commercial, expenditure means government. And what is the new nomenclature for this earnings is? Yeah, I will launch a small quiz. Please attempt all answers to the quiz. Please submit your answers. Yeah, any doubts, please raise the hands.
Medical reimbursement. Thank you. नहीं आएगी तो इसी ना तो ऑर्डर भेजे कि वहाँ भेजे मेरा तो कहना पड़ेगा ये पढ़ते कि पे ऑर्डर भेजे या कुछ और भेजे थे वहाँ से कुछ तो पे ऑर्डर करो ना पे ऑर्डर ही भेजे पर यह नहीं आएगी तो अजय जी से बात हुआ है
Should I post it? Yeah, all are admitted. Should I post it, Paul?
Yes, sir.
Please submit.
Yes, sir.
I'm going through the questions of last few years about LDC and FO both.
operating ratio, lots of the questions arises that operating ratio is not good enough for knowing the exact position of financial position of the railway. And that's why we also know in the including the ROR. ROR is the one of the factor by which it is. How can we write the and correlate these two indices, sir, to basically give a complete and good answer about when we ask about operating ratio as a measure or not?
Yeah, very good, but there is no capital and charge right now. Otherwise, we normally calculate the percentage of surplus to the capital and charge and investment from capital fund. But right now, the capital and charge is stands seized. There is no capital and charge in the books of our values. So, if there is any separate figure is there for investments or total capital, we can calculate that is rate of return or return on capital employed. But this is nothing but whether we are able to meet our regular expenditure with our earnings in the current year or not, that is operating ratio. That means, let me tell you, they are spending 250 rupees for earning 100 rupees. But because of government operation, we are not profitable, we are running the metro railway. Otherwise, no private company will run metro railway Calcutta. It is a private company. Because it is our social service obligation. Because we are serving the public, as a government, we are serving the office.
Means if we ask about the measures, what other options you suggested instead of operating ratio?
Other option means nothing but the return on capital employed. That is the best operating ratio or profitability ratio. That is gross profit ratio and net profit ratio.
Thank you so much.
Good afternoon. I have a question.
Yeah.
2 or 3 years, we do not have enough funds to appropriate to DRF.
Yes, exactly.
What is going to be the other alternative that we need to the capital assets?
Yeah, other alternative is nothing but to have for borrowed funds.
Are DRF going to be abolished?
No, not abolished, but there is no sufficient amount of person. There is no abolished person. It is there, but I'll show. See,
one person, sir?
Yeah, 1 minute. 1 minute. Let me clarify this one. Please. Yeah, please check. This is the 2020-21 last year CapEx budget. If you check this, here we have provided only 1,000 crores. But what is the share of this, divided by 16, what is the share of this budget support and internal resources? It's all nothing but 43 plus 5, 48%. If you check this extra budget and resources, this is 52%. That means half of the divided by 16, is met from the borrowed funds. Borrowed funds means IRFC 30,000 crores, EBRIF 28,000 crores, EBRPPP public trade partnership 26,000 crores. All together it is 83,000 crores. It means our share of internal resources is only 5%.
Surplus to
appropriate. What will this railways is increasing the price in the last 10 years? No.
We can do some purchases or purchase of assets or so from other borrowed funds or so. But what about the write backs or write off that we charge to DRF?
Yeah, write back, there is no question of write back because at the time of the end of the asset, it is sold to nominal price. Railways. So there is no empty in the for right back. Because if you purchase rolling stock by using capital, there is a question arise, right back question is arise. But there is no this capital, the user IRFC funds, But we are taking the all rolling stock on his basis. So there is no recording of the process as far as rolling stock is out. So where is the person of right back?
Okay, sir, thank you.
Yeah, any more?
Sir, one question, sir.
Yes,
sir. Sir, capital component of lead charging, sir.
Yes.
Paid to IRFC is demanded 16 and planned 2100, sir.
Capital component, because capital component is always charged to the number 16 and capital demand. So, suppose if you are paying EMI charge, please check in the EMI, the dedicated monthly installment of this housing loan consists of two components, that is principal component and interest component.
Yes, sir.
So, like that, the lease charge is also principal or capital component and interest component.
Any more questions? Someone wanted to ask some question, I think. Okay, no one. Yeah, we can end the session, Nageshwar Rao.
I have a question. Why the operating ratio alone is not termed as a reliable financial indicator for financial viability of
Pardon?
Why the operating ratio alone is not termed as a reliable indicator?
No, who said it is not reliable? It is a label only, but it is not final one.
Because
it is judging the operating efficiency, whether we are solvent or not. That means whether we are able to meet our expenses, our earnings or not, the operating ratio is contained.
Because the appropriation to DRF is always a questionable figure.
But we are not bound by the company's
act. HRM is Skylark banta
hai. We are bound by the company's act.
Sir, do we get any step wise marking in the examination for writing operating ratio, solving the operating ratio numerically?
Yeah, it is depend on the question asked. Suppose if you ask the find out the operating ratio from the given figures, we have to find this one. To solve the problem, or we have to arrange this calculation of operating ratio.
Sir, likewise,
what are the measures?
Sir, likewise in the previous exam of MTCA, I have got 0 marks in the whole 20 question because I have used your table like in Appendix B, your website, and from that table I used to mark the answer, but actually I got one wrong figure and put that wrong figure in the formula. So I got 0 marks in the both two parts of the question.
It's a discretion of the evaluator. Normally for a small mistake they won't want 0 marks. There is proportionately a reduction in marks in the subject. Because they consider other aspects of the logs. Whether you are able to understand the operating ratio or not, they will check.
Yes, sir. Actually, I have got my copy from the railway home, and I saw in that they have awarded me 0 marks in that question. And I have written all the formulas for operating ratio and one other thing. This type of thing has happened.
Yeah. Next. Sir.
Alright. Okay.
Thanks.
On behalf of Sitara, we thank Nageshwar Rao Garu for his wonderful lecture with examples, so that it will be very clear to all the aspiring participants for the exam, departmental examinations. Tomorrow, the session starts at 11 o'clock. The topic is pension matters. The speaker is Dr. Sri P. Rajadurai, Deputy Chief Accounts Officer, South Central Railway, Secunderabad. Login time, as usual, is 11 o'clock. The session will start at all are welcome. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.